Then we write our next compatibility equation, which is nothing but deformation equation. Now we know together steel and copper bar as a composite section elongated by delta L equal to 1.5 mm. So we have the compatibility equation as delta L of steel is same as that of delta L of copper. Expand this equation of delta L for steel as well as copper. We have free expansion of steel plus induced expansion is equal to free expansion of copper plus induced contraction. Point to be noted here is, in this case we have not written expansion prevented or expansion or contraction prevented. Why? Because there is as such no supports or ends which is preventing its expansion or contraction. Rather, we have the two steel and copper bar which is inducing the effects on each other. Like steel is inducing the compressive effect on copper, whereas the copper is inducing the tensile effect on steel. However, the formula does not change. We have free expansion of steel as alpha s delta t into L plus sigma s L upon es equal to alpha c delta t into L plus sigma c L upon ec. Now in this equation everything is in positive, but finally after finding out the answer you will find out the stress in any one of the steel or copper will be in negative, meaning that compression. Now as we have already talked about, the copper is in compression, so sigma c will come out to be negative. Now upon substituting the values, we have alpha s is 2L into 10 to the power minus 6 into delta t is 300. You will see that LL and here LL will get cancelled. So we have plus sigma s upon es, which is 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 newton per meter square. This is equal to 17.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 multiplied by 300 plus sigma c upon ec. Ec is 1 into 10 to the power 5. Now let this be equation 2. Now substituting from 1 in equation 2, we get that is sigma s in terms of sigma c. So your sigma s will be minus 2 sigma c. Now while solving, taking this term on this side whereas this term on the right hand side, we get minus 5.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 is equal to 2 sigma c upon 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 plus sigma c upon 1 into 10 to the power 5. Now this was your sigma s term which was on the left hand side and it was plus sigma s. Now plus sigma s is minus 2 sigma c. So when this sigma c term came here, it become plus 2 sigma c. So plus 2 sigma c upon 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 plus this. So upon solving this, we get the value of sigma c as minus 84 newton per mm square. Negative sign indicates that stress developed on copper bar is compressive. Now upon substituting this value of sigma c in equation 1, we get the corresponding stress in steel as sigma s is minus 2 sigma c. So this becomes minus 2 into minus 84 and it is 169.02 newton per mm square. And since this is positive, the stress on steel bar is tensile. Though we had assumed that the load developed in steel and copper bar as both tensile in our first static equilibrium equation, we got finally the answer same as what we had discussed. Next we find out the original length of the system. For this again we use the delta L equation. We have delta L as 1.5 mm. So this delta L can be either delta L of steel rod or delta L of copper bar. So this delta L can be either of delta L of steel bar or delta L of copper bar. So I take this as delta L of steel bar. Writing the formula for delta L of steel, we get alpha s delta t L plus sigma s into L upon es is equal to 1.5 mm. Alpha s is 2L into 10 to the power minus 6 multiplied by 300 multiplied by length L plus sigma s we get as 169.02 upon es is 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 multiplied by L is equal to 1.5. So taking L together, we get the value of L as 340.5 mm, meaning that 0.34 meter. Now this is the original length of steel and copper bar at temperature 15 degrees centigrade. So with this, our problem is over. Thanks for watching in 5 minutes.